This is Diane Roberts. The painting is Your Baby Ain't Sweet Like Mine.
Look at this picture. There she is, just a whomping on something or somebody down there. We don't know who, we don't know what, but she's having a big time with it. Whatever's down there isn't having such a big time because I think I see blood flying. But anyway, I hope she can get that dress dry cleaned. It is the most amazing picture to me because not only is there so much joy as she swings that axe, and rage as well, but there is a sense that whatever that is or whoever that is so had it coming. Now, we don't know if she's a bride or a debutante or the homecoming queen or the May queen or Miss Springtime Tallahassee. She could be a lot of things with her dress, and she's wearing those little puffy sleeves and the long gloves, but she's definitely engaged in her axe handling, shall we call it. And you can see this is a wonderful Florida painting because we've got all these palmettos and palms. So she just needs a little bit of that spooky light, little moonlight to accomplish her deed. And she's going. And you know, the title of the painting, I believe, is Your Baby Ain't Sweet Like Mine. And well, she's sweet all right, and whoever she's whomping on sweet now, because whoever it is isn't giving her any trouble. I think this is a very narrative painting. I think there's a story in back of this. I don't know what it is, but I do know that, you know, ladies in white dresses with gloves and sleeves and big poofy skirts have sometimes felt the need to kill people. But they mostly needed killing these people. It's not like that she's just killing to kill. Whoever this is, or whatever it is, needed killing. Now I want to draw your attention to the fabric on the dress. You can see this is a super expensive dress, which, like I say, I hope she can dry clean that blood off of there, because it's a nice dress and you hate to have it ruined. But I'm thinking that, you know, in a lot of Southern stories, justice can't be done by the law. It's only accomplished by individual actions, which occasionally involve a gun or machete or poison, or in this case, a very sharp hatchet. You can see by the light glinting on the blade that this is a very sharp hatchet. And whoever she is and whatever she's doing, I feel that she has every right to do it. Maybe the law wouldn't see it that way, but I kind of think that something big happened and she needs to deal with it. Now, if you look again real closely at the painting, you'll see there's at least one critter, maybe more, in those palmettos, kind of watching. They look like panthers to me, but I'm not really sure what they are. And I think in every great occasion, in every life-changing event, it's important that there be a feline. And I think there are felines here. I know that for myself, everything I do that's important, there's a feline nearby. Cat or kitten or, you know, on a good day, Florida panther. But at least a cat. And here she is, and whacking away with the cat, watching. Perhaps it's a god cat or a goddess cat. Perhaps that cat is her spirit animal. Perhaps that is what incited the whole thing. Perhaps the person or the thing under there tried to hurt the cat. And, well, you try to hurt a cat, let me just say, the wages of cat hurting involve an axe on you. So you might not want to go there. Stuart Riordan's work is haunting. It is gothic. It is funny. And it's immensely stylish. Very few women can wear gloves and puffy sleeves and a strapless ball dress like this lady can. We cannot see her face, but we don't need to. This is a very, very chic, funny, angry, dark, brilliant piece of work. And the light coming in, glinting on that blade, is the light of righteousness.